Good morning, Shraddha. Good morning, Tanmay. How are you all?
Good morning, ma'am. Fine, ma'am. How are you, ma'am?
I am also good. So today we are, like, I am 5 minutes late. Let us wait for others.
Good morning.
Good morning, good morning. Somebody, two more people need to join. Na? Shreyash is there and Raghuram. Everybody know that today's class?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, Shraddha, you were having some puja yesterday in the morning?
Yes, ma'am. I had a puja. That's why I couldn't come.
So, what, like, which type of puja it was?
Ma'am, like a Shanti puja.
Oh, Shanti puja. Okay. So, this puja is for how many hours? Like, if you will start or if we start in morning, then how much time does it take?
Ma'am, we actually went like around 10:30 and it got over at 2:30.
Oh. That's the reason you were able to attend only evening class then.
Yes, ma'am.
Wrong. Oh, I can see only two people have joined. I don't know why this two, Raghuram and Shesh, are not there. So shall we start? Yesterday, Tanmay was there. So
yes.
Those who were absent, they can simply see the recording once it will be uploaded. Let me check it. That is there somebody who's trying to come? No, there is no nothing invitation like that. I will try to put on my video. Hello. So today we will start the pending part of the microbes in human welfare. Here it is little cold.
You are not in Bangalore?
I am in Bangalore only, but I feel cold in morning. Yes, it is. Sun is there, but it's not coming in my home. Like sunlight is not coming in my home in early morning. Like around 12 or 1 o'clock, it will be there, little sunny.
Yes, ma'am.
So yesterday, what we have done, quickly I will go through the recap. We were studying the useful effect of microbes in different fields. So in different field, the first field was microbes in household product. Okay? First, we have done that about curd and what we have done. Curd we have done. And one more thing was there, toddy, and this all we have done. Then second, cheese was also there. After this, microbes in industrial product. In industry, we have done two application, beverages and antibiotics. After this, acha, in antibiotics, Tanmay was there in the class. So please tell me, along with Alexander Fleming, name the two more scientists who worked for antibiotic and got Nobel Prize. Along with Alexander Fleming, name two scientists.
Ma'am, I don't know.
Check your notes. I told you yesterday, I taught you. Check your notes. Shraddha, can you try?
Ma'am, Chain and Flory.
Very good. Ernest Chain and Howard Flory. So then after we have done effect of microbes in creating, producing chemicals, enzymes, other bioactive molecules that are very, very useful in medical field, like statins are there that will lower the cholesterol. Cyclosporine was there that will act as an immunosuppressive agent. Then streptokinase, clot buster, heart attack patient. This we have done. After that, we have to start today microbes in sewage treatment. Then we will study biochemical oxygen demand, BOD. After that, microbes in production of biogas. See, when the sewage will be there, when we will do sewage treatment, at that time only biogas will be produced. Then we will do little detail that what are the gases in biogas, which bacteria is responsible and all this, okay? Then microbe as biocontrol agent and microbe as biofertilizer. So today, I hope I will be able to complete this chapter. Maybe it will be like, it get over like at 12 o'clock or 12:30 only, then you can leave. Is that fine?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay, so everybody open your notebook. Let me also set my writing pad so that we can start making notes and then you can understand. And guys, just I want feedback also in the end, so that is there anything that you want from my side, I will do it in the next class. Otherwise, I will not be able to know now that how the class is going. Are you satisfied? There is something that we need to do. Okay, don't be shy. What happened? Oh, your voice is like getting echo. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
My screen, please tell me, is it visible?
Yes, ma'am, it's visible.
Pakka?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So here I would like to open my IPO, that is writing pad. So today, guys, when there will be now somebody telling in my class, somebody want to come, like invitation will be there. So please let me know, because here I'm not able to see, like two boys are missing now. Okay, I hope now there is no disturbance. Below my apartments, some kids start playing from early morning 7 o'clock till 9:30 p.m. So they will create disturbance. Now there is no unnecessary voice.
Yes, ma'am, now it's fine.
And try to speak as much in the class so that the class doesn't become boring. It should be engaging. Like if I ask something, you have to speak. If you have any problem, you have to say to me. So the topic is microbes. See, this is something that is very, very confusing. And it takes a lot of time, lot of patience to understand microbes in sewage treatment. Lot of sewage is there because of pollution. Wait. Everybody is having their notebook?
Yes, ma'am.
So microbes in sewage treatment. So there is culture of Indian and Western toilet in our country. But before this toilet, we can understand that nobody was going, nobody was having toilets at all in their home. Simply they go to farm. Do you remember in ancient days, nobody was having this toilet. People carry their mug. Oh, Aditya is there. So people carry their mug and then they go. Hello, Aditya. Hello, hello, hello. Good morning. Can you hear me? Oh, I got a message. Oh, chalo. So we are discussing sewage treatment. We are discussing sewage treatment. So in old days, if you remember, in ancient days, there were no system of toilets in India. People generally go in farm. So there was no system of, you can also say, a sewage treatment ka koi funda hi nahi tha. There was nothing to do with the treatment of the sewage. But slowly, slowly, when urbanization took place, urbanization means township. People are moving from village to city in search of good life, good education, okay, good food. So what happened? They have started building their own home. And when they were having their own house, their own home, then they were having their own toilets. So in every toilet is having one system by the help of which the human excreta will go out. Theek hai? Everybody goes toilet in the morning. Some people use it for the two time. So there is a lot of human excreta. So human excreta makes lot of organic effluent. The human excreta is having organic effluent. So here I will write. Everybody have to write along with me in your notebook. Human excreta makes organic effluent. So this organic effluent is need to be treated, guys, because can we throw directly these organic effluent to the rivers? Can we allow the organic effluent that is coming from everybody's washroom in this whole India? Can we directly throw it in the river? Water body source? No, because it is very, very harmful. Na, the whole water will become dirty. And it will become, you can say, source of so many waterborne disease. Everybody will have polio, then amebiasis, cholera, jaundice, typhoid. Okay, so it's better to, before throwing the water, this organic effluent, before throwing this organic effluent in the river, it should be treated. It should be treated. And for this treatment, there is a sewage treatment plant. If you have NCRT, I will tell you, please open your NCRT. Let me complete my statement. Sewage treatment plant is there. But guys, do you know, just because there is so much population in our country, that according to the population, the number of sewage treatment plant is less. So it is little struggle, but still government is trying. Yes, government is actually trying to make more and more sewage treatment plant. So where is my NCRT? Everybody have NCRT in their hand? Everybody have NCRT? Bolo bachcha party.
Yes, ma'am.
Tanmay and Aditya, why you are not using your mic? Feeling shy in the class? Chalo, go to the page number 185, figure 10.7. Page 185, figure 10.7. Visible? An aerial view of a sewage plant.
Yes, ma'am.
So after looking this, can you say that it is so beautiful and here there is treatment of sewage is done? It's look like a something lab work is going on, something productive is going on, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
Why you everybody is feeling so low in the morning only? Didn't you have some breakfast or something?
Nothing like that, ma'am.
Okay. Why was drinking water? See, so microbes will be used in order to treat the sewage so that it becomes least polluted. And when it becomes least polluted, then we can allow them to go into the river source. Hi, Raghuram.
Hello. Sorry, I'm late, ma'am.
It's okay. Today I was also 5. The lecture started at 9:05. I got a little late. It's okay, but we have started. I hope you have, you have attended last lecture. Then after break, you were having power cut or something, na?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, it's okay. The recording will be uploaded. I asked Santosh sir in the office. He told that maybe today evening or tomorrow morning, recording will be there. So after every class, you will get the recording. So we are doing sewage treatment by the help of sewage treatment plant and microbes. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
This sewage treatment is done in the two ways. Everyone, it is my request that please focus, especially this topic, because it is a damn confusing topic. If you will not study properly, little focus is required. Once the doubt will be clear, you are not going to forget throughout your life. So sewage treatment is done in two steps. Step number first is primary treatment. Okay, primary treatment. Second is, as it is second, then it will be secondary treatment. Now, what is the difference between primary treatment and secondary treatment? First of all, listen, in primary treatment, P for primary, P for physical. P for primary, P for physical. So primary treatment is physical treatment. In this, simply we have to do a filtration process, sedimentation process. We will not add microbes in primary treatment. The step in which microbes are used is secondary. So secondary may we will use microbes. So this will become also known as biological treatment. Why biological? Because we are using microbes. Okay, is it fine? Itna pakka ho gaya? P for primary, P for physical, S for secondary, S may we will use microbe. Then it will become biological. Crystal clear?
Yes, ma'am.
A little more detail. In physical treatment, we will have two steps. First is filtration. Okay. And second is sedimentation. Okay, so in physical treatment, we have to study filtration process and sedimentation process. In biological treatment, what will be added? What we will add so that our water become little clean? Sewage water become
microbes.
Clean? Addition of microbes. Okay, so this much everybody have written in your notes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so guys, now here I will make one drawing. Okay, diagram here I will draw one. See, this is a big tank. This is a big tank like this. Okay, so here what we are adding? Sewage water. I will make it with brown color, dirty. Sewage water is being added. Sewage water is being added in this tank for the treatment. So both treatment will be done, primary and secondary, but first primary. Primary is physical. So what will happen in order to, what was the first step of primary treatment?
Filtration,
very good. So in order to do filtration, we have filters. Obviously, filtration is there, so we have to use filter now. So here is a filter. Let me draw it. These are the filters. Filter number one is having big filters, but in filter number two, the filters will become Fine or more big?
Fine.
Fine. So I will draw it also. Everybody make tea in their home. So you do filter of the tree, na? Filtration of the tree by using filter. So tea leaves and ginger extract, everything will remain in the filter. See, so much disturbance. Can you hear? Kids are playing.
Yes,
ma'am. They are simply love to play. No offline class, online class. So they are enjoying. So dekho, so in the first step is filtration. So these two are filters. So which step will be done here? First step we will do filtration. Okay. After this, this filtration will be a part of primary treatment. This sewage water, after getting filter, it will go. It will become little clear. Not much, little clear, but it will become. The water that is present here, water after primary treatment, like or not primary, like water after this, we can say when the filter, oh God, when the filtration is done, see this is the filtration process by the using filter, then this water will have small and large soil particle, sand particle, clay is there, grit is there, na? That is not filtered in this filter. So they will go and settle down like this. They will go and settle down. See, they are properly getting settled down. So the settling down of the clay and grit particles, this step is known as the second step of physical treatment is, the second step of physical treatment is
sedimentation.
Very good. So here I will write step number two, sedimentation. So physical treatment is done. Physical treatment is done in two ways. First step is filtration. Second is sedimentation. So after doing these two process, after doing these filtration and sedimentation, physical treatment, primary treatment is over. Now the water that is left here after primary treatment, this is known as primary sludge. What is the name? Primary sludge. Okay. Now this primary sludge, we can also say after sedimentation, the water of sewage left in the tank is known as effluent or primary sludge, or you can say it is known as supernatant. So we can call it primary sludge, effluent, supernatant. So many names are there. Supernatant. Okay, so there is supernatant. After this, what we will understand, is this water pure to go into the river?
Not yet, ma'am.
Not yet, because in order to make it a little more clear, this effluent needed to go for which treatment? This effluent should pass for? Who will tell?
Secondary treatment.
So the effluent, we will allow them to go for secondary treatment. And in secondary treatment, what will be added? In secondary treatment, what will be added? Speak. Everything is written on the board.
Microbes.
Only Shraddha is speaking. What about others? Mic is not working. Hello, class 12. Are you able to understand anything?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Is there a little disturbance, background noise?
It's a bit, ma'am. It's fine.
But, okay. So secondary treatment, microbe is there. In microbe is added, so this treatment also known as biological treatment. Okay. So this primary sludge will go for secondary treatment. In secondary treatment, one tank is used. That tank is known as aeration tank. What is the tank used in secondary treatment? Aeration tank. Now I will change my slide. May I? Have you written all these things?
Yes, ma'am.
I will change my slide. We will go to slide number. Oh, we came to 4. How many slides we have done? Wait. Have I skipped some slides? Okay. This is something that we don't know. Okay, fine. So this is board number 3. So aeration tank will be there. The primary sludge will go in the aeration tank and then the aeration tank will agitate. Have you seen washing machine? When you put clothes and water and detergent, then it will start moving, agitating. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
So there is little amount of air is also. And then when the washing machine is agitating, there will be bubbles of the detergent that is present at the top of the machine. If you open it, then you can see. Yes? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
So biological treatment, there will be use of aeration tank. In this aeration tank, there will be primary sludge. Aeration tank mein what will be there? There will be primary sludge. This primary sludge will be aeration is there. Aeration tank is there. So which process will take place? Agitation. Okay, primary sludge is also known as effluent or supernatant. Okay. So agitation is happening. It means air is pumped into it. Agitation is happening. It means air is pumped into it. So what will happen now? Once the secondary treatment has started, the aeration tank along with primary sludge is agitating goal, 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 round and round and round. So here one more diagram. This is aeration tank. Okay. Now this aeration tank here, I will write it also. Otherwise you will forget. This is secondary treatment, guys. Aeration tank is there. So this brown color, what was remaining part of the sewage after primary treatment, what we have called it? What we call sewage that has undergone primary treatment and going for secondary treatment, what is the name?
Primary sludge.
Primary sludge, effluent, supernatant. Very good. So here, this is primary sludge. So let me write it down. This is the effluent. See, all are same thing again and again. So this effluent, primary sludge, supernatant, this is biological treatment. So what we will add here? In biological?
Microbes.
Microbes, chalo. So I will make yellow microbes like this. Microbes are there. Okay, so what will happen? See, microbes, when they entered into the aeration tank, they want food in order to grow, in order to survive. They want air in order to breathe. Yes or no? If something is living, so food, air,
is necessary for them. So this microbe will get oxygen. From where they will get oxygen?
Microbe, I will make here little story. Abhi microbe wants to grow. We want to grow. For the growth of microbes, what is needed?
Oxygen.
Food. Second thing.
Food and oxygen. Is this fine? Till here, any doubts?
No doubts, ma'am.
No doubts. Now listen carefully. Oxygen they are getting from where they are getting oxygen? You remember, agitation process is taking place in this aeration tank. In agitation, air is also coming. We will allow the air to go inside. So from air, they will get water. From air, they will get oxygen. Food, from where they will get this effluent? Basically, what is effluent? Effluent is sewage only, na guys. It is,
yes, ma'am.
Little clean sewage. So sewage. So what we can say, this sewage is made up of organic matter. If you remember, sewage, human excreta is organic matter. So this organic matter will behave like a food for the microbes. Is it fine? This organic matter, that is effluent, will act as a food for microbe. And aeration tank, agitation is happening, air is getting supplied. So there will be what? There will be air supply, so they will get oxygen. So both necessary requirement is fulfilled by the microbes or not? Food and oxygen they are getting, yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
So what will happen as a result of which they will grow? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
They will grow. Very good. So after their growth, they are growing. Okay. And along with their growth, aeration tank is moving goal and goal and goal, round and round and round. So agitation is also happening. Growth of microbe is also happening. So what will happen? When you use your washing machine, it will move round and round and round. But when you will open it, you will observe the bubbles of the detergent and everything is at the top. Have you observed? At the top, there will be something when you open your washing machine. So see, listen, just because of continuous agitation of this aeration tank and growth of microbes, what will happen? There will be formation of plaque at the top. Here I will make. See, what is plaque here I am making? This is something, structure that is formed at the top. And in this plaque, these microbes will be trapped, guys. These microbes, they will come at the top. And they will be trapped.
Ma'am?
Yes?
Ma'am, is that froth?
No, F-L-O-C. It's written in NCRT, F-L-O-C-S. Page number 184. Froth is a normal word. Froth is a normal word in which detergent and everything comes at the top. But if there is microbe in biology, we call it flocks. Page number 184, if you want to clear the spelling, I have NCRT also. Okay, so all the microbes will be trapped. Okay, guys, microbe is aerobic or anaerobic?
Aerobic. They use oxygen.
That is why they want oxygen. So here the microbes will be trapped. So what I will write? Microbes are trapped. Plus, along with microbes, there are some fungal filaments are also formed in this process. So this microbe and fungal, they both will become a new name we will give. Just give me 1 minute, guys. It's a huge disturbance in my head. Just give me 1 minute. Just 1 minute hold I want so that I can change my position and I go to a better place. Hold on. Till then, please you make the diagram. Is there any doubt in diagram making also?
No, ma'am.
So please complete the diagram. Till then, I will change my position because I'm getting disturbed here. Hello everyone, can you hear me properly?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, so now I came in my study room because there was a little disturbance. Just let me sit and then I will start. So microbes are aerobic or anaerobic?
Aerobic.
Very nice. So aerobic respiration they will do. Then do agitation is continuously taking place in the aeration tank. So they will grow, they will get agitated, and in the end they will come at the top of the aeration tank. Then they will get trapped and they will make fungal filaments also. So microbes are trapped plus fungal filaments. So what we will call that structure? I have told you also it starts with the letter F. It starts with the letter F also. Use your common sense. Who will tell the answer? I have told you. Shraddha was having doubt also in that.
Could you repeat the question?
My question is, when the microbes come at the top of the aeration tank, they get trapped and they are really, they are going to associate it with fungal filaments. So what are they known as?
Flocks.
Flocks, very nice. Somebody else want to come in the class? Who is this? I don't know. Is this somebody classmate? Is there any kid that is not in the class?
Yes, ma'am.
Who? Name?
Ma'am, Shreyas is not.
Shreyas is not there. Oh, somebody is maybe from faculty. So this is known as flock. Here I will write it down. Microbes are trapped plus fungal filaments. Okay, this is neat MCQ. They will ask it. In 2018, they have asked also previous year question. So after this, microbes are getting trapped. Microbes need oxygen, microbe need food. So what will happen? They will go at the top and they will get trapped and they will make flocks. Is the water clean to go into the river now? We have done treatment, two type of treatment we have done. Is the water clean now? Say yes, 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 or no, no, no.
Ma'am, you can purify it more.
Ma'am, you could use chemicals to purify it more, I guess.
So see what we will do now. Here I will tell you. This effluent that is not having microbes now, because all the microbes are trapped and they have made flock. So this effluent, we will allow them to go after secondary treatment. Effluent will go into settling tank, guys. We call tank, so many tank and tank. Settling tank. Abhi dekho, what is settling tank? Aeration tank ke baad, there will be one settling tank. So here only a small, I will draw it. So after secondary treatment, the effluent is the effluent. Why I am making it blue color? Any idea? Any idea why I am using blue color?
Because color will be blue.
Not color blue, because now the water is little clean. So I have stopped using dark, dirty brown color and I have done with blue color. So this effluent, all the microbes have gone in above to make flock, but still there are few tiny microbes. So what they will do in this settling tank, these tiny microbes, they will go and get settled in the bottom. Okay, they will get settled. So here what I will write, microbes settling down. Microbes settling down. Okay? So microbes got set down and this upper part is what? Effluent. Now the microbe that is settled down, this is known as activated sludge. There was one primary sludge and now this one is known as activated sludge. So activated sludge is having the microbes. Now this activated sludge, the microbe that is present in this activated sludge, these microbes are only there now, that is settled down and making this activated sludge. They will undergo two steps. They have two functions. First, little microbe will used as an inoculum and it will go back to aeration tank. Abhi dekho, kya hoga? First step, what is the destiny of these microbes of activated sludge? There is two destiny. Destiny number one is little microbe or few microbes used as inoculum. You remember the word inoculum yesterday I have used? Yes or no? What is inoculum?
I'm a starter.
Very good, a starter. Something that starts something. So little microbe used as inoculum and where it will go and go back to which tank?
The aeration tank.
The aeration tank. Very good. So what I will do, this little microbe, I will send it to the aeration tank. This is my aeration tank. So here I have sent the microbes. So here I will make the blue microbes. Tick. So this is the first destiny of the microbe of activated sludge. Second destiny is that the remaining part, see, little only going now. Still there is 80%. So what will happen to that 70 to 80%? The major microbe, they will, remaining will do anaerobic sludge digestion. Without any oxygen, they will do respiration. Anaerobic sludge digestion. Okay. Now, after doing this anaerobic sludge digestion, what will happen? Whatever flocks was present here, whatever flocks, like flocks means microbe and fungus, whatever is present, everything will be digested. Everything will be digested. So here I will write anaerobic sludge digestion, digest. Sab bacha kucha, sab khatam, khalas, saaf, digest. All the flocks made in aeration tank. Made in aeration tank. Okay. Now this one, this is the destiny number two. In destiny number one, why we are using this little microbe as a starter in this aeration tank? Why we are using? What is the need? Why we are using again and again? Anybody who can tell me the answer? Oh, Shreyas want to come. So late people are joining now. Hi Shreyas. Oh, we haven't joined. Good morning, Shreyas.
Good morning, ma'am.
Why are you late?
Ma'am, I didn't see the winter planner properly, so I actually didn't see that today there was a class at this time. Sorry, ma'am.
Oh, no need to. Sorry. See, remember, guys, I will be with you till Friday. I have started my planner yesterday. I will continue till Friday, and then I think Saturday or Sunday, Vatsala, ma'am, and then Rahul, sir, they will be back Saturday, Sunday. Back, like, they will have their own chapter. Na? Ma'am is teaching molecular basis of inheritance and all this. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
क्यों इतना शांति है क्लास में इतनी 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 शांति फीलिंग स्लीपी
नो मैम
चलो सो माय क्वेश्चन वाज नाउ लिसन केयरफुली व्हाई दिस लिटिल माइक्रोब इज यूज्ड एज इनोकुलम एंड व्हाई डज इट नीड टू गो बैक टू द एरेशन टैंक. The answer is, when this little microbe will come back to aeration tank, they will again get food, they will again get oxygen, they will again get growth, and then they will again get and form flock. So again and again, when this process is taking place, the growth of microbe is happening. So microbe is eating all the organic matter of the water, like effluent. It's taking all the oxygen of the effluent. So in indirect way, it is making the water clean. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
See, microbes are there. So they are eating organic matter of the effluent. Human excreta, they are consuming it as their food. So don't you think indirectly our water is becoming clean? Abhi kya ho raha hai? Microbe have to get their food. So they are eating their food. What food they are eating? They are eating organic matter. Human excreta, that is a part of this effluent. So they will eat all the food and then they will go get trapped in the filter that is above. So in what will be the result? This effluent will be clean na? Yes or no? Use your common sense.
Yes, ma'am.
So in this way, we will make this effluent clean twice. ठीक है, सब सफाई करना है. We have to clean. That is why we are doing all this process. Now this anaerobic sludge, this settling tank was there. Microbes settled down. Few microbes use as a inoculum. Most of the microbes are getting anaerobic respiration, and then they will be digested. Digest all the flocks made in the aeration tank. ठीक है, very good. Now after this, what will happen? After doing all this process, they will release one gas. When they will do this digestion of flock and all, the bad smell gas will be there, and it is known as, what is that? Biogas. So this process will release biogas. So don't you think that sewage treatment plant is useful also in two ways? One, so we are getting rid of the pollution, okay, and second, we are getting biogas. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Ek teer se do nishane. How many people understand Hindi? Little bit.
I guess everybody here.
Everybody, very good. So this is a idiom, guys. Muhavre. Ek teer se do nishane means you are doing one thing and you are getting two outputs. So we are doing treatment of the wastewater. What are the two outputs we are getting? First output we are getting that the water is becoming less polluted after treatment. Second is that we are getting a biogas. Fine. So this biogas is made up of methane, hydrogen sulfide, carbon dioxide. Fine. Write it down. After this, I will teach you BOD. It is also related to this topic. BOD, we have to do. First complete this and then let me know that, ma'am, we have done the notes and now you can continue. Then am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Everybody have done the notes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, very good. So here I will start a new small chotu sa topic that is known as BOD. I hope this word you have heard already. Have you heard this word before?
No, ma'am.
Okay, first time, fine. Biochemical oxygen demand. The short form is BOD. Biochemical oxygen demand. Now listen carefully. If the water is more polluted, the BOD will be high. If the water is less polluted, the BOD will be low. For example, this is polluted water. I will say high polluted water, this arrow. And this will be less polluted water. Okay. So in high polluted water, suppose the same thing, this is water, this is water. Water is polluted, it means microbes will be there. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
So these are all our microbes. So the microbes that are living in high polluted water, they also want food. Everywhere, wherever there is microbe, they want food. Okay, fine. So in this more polluted water, organic matter will be more or less? In high polluted water, organic matter will be more or less? Organic matter, excreta.
It'll be more, ma'am.
More, very good. So more organic matter. Okay, point number two, they will have this microbe, more organic matter, like more food is there for microbe. So microbe will grow more, yes or no? More growth of microbes. So do these microbes need oxygen?
Yes, ma'am.
So more oxygen they need for their growth. More oxygen is needed. So in this way, the oxygen that is present in this waste water, in this polluted water, sewage water, that will be used by the microbe. So there will be deficiency of oxygen in the sewage water of oxygen. Why? Because all the oxygen was used up by microbe. So the oxygen demand, the you can say deficiency of oxygen will be there. So we can say that this polluted water have what we will say, high BOD. Because why the biochemical oxygen demand is more? Because all the oxygen is used by, because all the oxygen is used by
The microbes, ma'am.
Microbes. So there is lack of oxygen, so their BOD will become high. Is it okay? Is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. After this, let us move to less polluted water. Here, organic matter will be more or less. Less organic matter, less sewage water, less excreta, less organic matter. Okay, this is known as less food. When there is less food, what will be the amount of oxygen here?
It should be lower.
So when less organic matter is there, so growth of the microbe will be more or less. When there is food also less, when there is oxygen also less. Less oxygen is there, less food is there. So what will be the growth of microbes?
That will also reduce.
It will also reduce. So less growth of microbes. Less growth of microbe. And when this growth of microbe will be less, already less oxygen is there. So what we can say, BOD is more or less?
Ma'am, yeah, it will be less.
Everything will be less. Low biochemical oxygen demand. So we can simply say more the polluted water, more the BOD, less the polluted water, less the BOD. Can we say biochemical oxygen demand, biochemical oxygen demand is directly proportional to, biochemical oxygen demand is directly proportional to, who will tell me? Pollution. Am I correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Biochemical oxygen demand is directly proportional to pollution. Okay, fine. Note it down. So more the BOD, more the pollution. More and more growth of microbes requires more food and oxygen. When these microbes takes the nutrition, polluted water will be more toxic. Their BOD will increase, as a result of which the BOD of the effluent will decrease. Hence, the water becomes less polluted. Is there any disturbance?
No, ma'am, it's fine.
See, I came in my room, still in the corridor. The kids are jumping and moving here and there. I don't know when the school will be open and they will go to school. Done.
Mom, could you scroll a little up? Done, ma'am.
Okay. Then this is done. So guys, if I say the main agenda of this secondary or biological treatment of the sewage water is to decrease the BOD of the polluted water, am I correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, see, BOD we have to decrease. I don't know from where this noise is coming. But BOD is a measure of the organic matter present in the water. So here I will write it down. What is our main agenda, main aim? The main aim, or we can say agenda of secondary treatment, guys, because in secondary only microbes are used. The main agenda of secondary treatment is to reduce the BOD of polluted water. To reduce the BOD of polluted water. Is it okay? So yes, now ma'am. Listen carefully. Previous year question here, what comes in NEET? That I will tell you. Previous year, one question came. The question was, BOD is a measure of, and there were so many options. There was option like, BOD is a measure of oxygen content in the water. BOD is a measure of nutrition content in the water. BOD is a measure of organic matter present in the water. So many kids get confused. Even I was getting confused when I was doing this 12th grade. I have marked oxygen. Okay. I have marked oxygen, but that is wrong. BOD is a measure of, what should be the answer according to you?
My
organic matter. Very good. See, BOD, dekho, ek bar first it will measure organic matter. Then automatically we will get to know that if there will be less organic matter, so obviously the growth of the microbe will be less. So there will be less oxygen also in that water. So BOD is a measure of organic matter. Organic matter like human excreta and all in the water. This is something that we need to learn. Very, very important. Okay. So more the BOD, more the pollution. Am I correct? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So this you write it down. After this, biogas, here we have to understand that how microbe is used in the production of biogas. See, we have understood already that in the wastewater treatment, biogas is released. Yes or no? We are getting two things. First, the water is also becoming treated. Secondly, we get a gas known as biogas. So biogas is a mixture of methane, carbon dioxide, H2S that we have discussed. But we will go a little more in detail because in NCERT there is a topic, microbes in production of biogas. Yes or no? Acha, tell me, who will tell me, when the effluent is in the settling tank, and the microbes that get settled down in the settling tank, you remember they were known as activated sludge and then they are going to be digested.
Yes, ma'am.
So what type of respiration they have done? Aerobic or anaerobic?
Wouldn't they have undergone aerobic respiration?
No, I am saying the settling tank microbes. See, few microbes were used as inoculum. They went back to aeration tank, but still 70-80% of the activated sludge, they were digested. So which type of respiration they have done so that they can release biogas? Ek respiration hua tha, the microbe have done respiration as a result of which they have released biogas. What was the respiration? Aerobic, anaerobic? Everybody have to tell. This is direct from the notes.
Could you repeat the question?
My question is, in the settling tank, in wastewater treatment, in secondary treatment, there is a settling tank. In that settling tank, there are microbes that are present in activated sludge. Listen to me. There are microbes present in the activated sludge. Out of all the microbes present in the activated sludge, few of them will go back as inoculum in the aeration tank. And most of them, like 70-80%, will be digested and then they will release a biogas. So those microbes which are digested, they are undergoing dash type of respiration.
Anaerobic,
guys, they will do anaerobic because once the microbe quantity got decreased, once the wastewater is getting treated in settling tank, almost the water is getting treated, the BOD became less, so the oxygen is less. So just because oxygen is less, so which type of respiration will be done?
Anaerobic.
There will be no oxygen only, na. So how the microbe will get oxygen? Bechare sab kya karenge? They will do anaerobic respiration and then they will, in the last, they will, due to lack of proper oxygen, they will die. But when they will die, they will release one gas. What is the gas? Arre bolo bhai, what is the gas?
Biogas.
Kya ho gaya, itni shanti kyun hai class mein, kuch samajh nahi aa raha hai kya?
I'm understood, ma'am.
To itna kyun, itna, arre bhai, bolo. अरे यू नीड टू बी क्विक एंड अटेंटिव ना, देन वी विल एंजॉय दिस चैप्टर. बायो में मोस्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर्स आर टोटल रट्टा, सो वी कांट डू रट्टा ऑल द टाइम ना, इट विल बिकम बोरिंग. ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट. नेक्स्ट इज microbes in production of biogas. Once I will do this topic, this is a little small topic, then we will have a break, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
So the topic name here I will write. Sorry. Can I trust you that you all are making notes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Microbes in production of biogas. Now, if I go to your previous knowledge, thoda sa here I will write one story. The story is that microbes that was present in activated sludge. What they have done, which type of respiration they have done? Anaerobic respiration. Okay, and as a result, what they have released? Biogas. Biogas is having CH4 H2S CO2. Now here previous year question was that what is the percentage of CH4 or methane? It is 50 to 60. I was writing 40, but it is now I got to remember 50 to 60% of methane. This is previous year question. So this microbe that is releasing biogas is having a special name. What is that name? Special name of the microbe that is releasing biogas.
Methanogens.
Methanogens. See, M for methanogens, M for methane they are releasing. So methanogens, you can say it is a group of, if you remember yesterday lecture, archaebacteria we have done. Thermoacidophiles and then methanogens and what was one more category? Three we have done archaebacteria, halophiles. Okay, so methanogens are a type of archaebacteria. They can live in extreme condition and all. So methanogens are responsible for production of biogas. Is it okay? Methanogens present in anaerobic sludge digester is known as methanobacteria. Ab ye methanogen, it was doing respiration or anaerobic respiration?
Anaerobic.
Anaerobic.
Anaerobic. So those methanogens which are doing anaerobic respiration, they are known as methanobacterium. Methanobacterium. Okay, so methanobacterium is that bacterium that is a type of methanogen that undergoes anaerobic respiration and it will release a gas known as biogas. Biogas is having methane, hydrogen sulfide and CO2. The important in this is that the composition of methane in biogas is like 50% to 60%. Is it okay?
Yes.
Who will tell me? If you remember yesterday lecture, I have high hopes from you. Like methanogens that is present, that is archaebacteria basically, where they, what is their location? Instead of this sewage, ignore this sewage treatment. Yesterday lecture.
I'm in the stomach of animals.
In the stomach of cattle, they are present. They look, the flavor, the taste of the cattle meat is just because of methanogens. This bacteria is there. Okay, they releases a gas, biogas in sewage, but there they will give a proper taste and smell. Okay, one more thing is there. Methanogens help in the digestion of cellulose by releasing an enzyme known as cellulase. Ab yahan pe, here I will tell you, as you were telling na, where is my yellow color? Methanogens, where they are present? They are present in normally stomach of cattle, correct? In cattle, can I write down cow, buffalo, goat? Am I correct? Am I correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So when these methanogens are present in the stomach of cattle, so they will release one enzyme. Release an enzyme. That is known as cellulase. And here one question will come in your brain, in your mind. Cow, buffalo, goat, they all are herbivorous, correct? They will eat plant. They will eat herb. They will have shrubs. Yes or no? In their diet. Theek hai? Correct? Thumbs up. If it is correct, put thumbs up. See till here, any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Now, when these animals, cow, buffalo, goat, they will eat plant. So the plant cell is made up of, plant cell is having cell wall. Yes or no? Who is this? Plant cell is having, thank you, Shraddha. Plant cell is having cell wall. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
cell
ma'am.
Wall is made up of?
Cellulose.
Cellulose, very good. So this cellulose needed to be digested in the cattle body. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
So cellulose will be digested by which enzyme? Cellulose get digested by?
Cellulase.
Cellulase. And from where we are getting cellulase?
Methanogen.
Methanogens. Methanogens are those bacteria that are present in the stomach of cattle. They will release cellulase. Cellulase will help in the digestion of cellulose that is present in the cell wall of the plant that is eaten by the cow, buffalo, goat. Fine? Understood? Wait out. So we can we say that methanogen, like methanobacteria, helps in digestion of food in cattle? Cattle eats grass and plant. Plant cell wall is made up of cellulose. Is this a statement justified?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So this is done. If I say, here I write a statement. Human can digest cellulose. Is this true or false? Give me answer. Human can digest cellulose. Is this true or false? True or false? Abhi kaun batayega? Who will tell me?
Ma'am, I guess false.
False. Okay, very good. Your answer is correct. Can you tell the reason also?
Ma'am, because we can't digest plant matter. We can't eat grass directly.
Because we don't have, we can't digest. Why we can't digest? We cannot digest cellulose. Theek hai. But why? Why we are unable to digest cellulose?
Because methanogens are absent in us.
Because we don't have cellulase. Who will release cellulase? Methanogens. We don't have methanogens. So basically, we cannot digest cellulose because we don't have cellulase. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
So here I will tell you one benefit. We are not able to digest cellulose. So whatever plant we will eat, for example, cucumber, radish, carrot, and what is there? What more? Spinach, green veggie, whatever these things we eat, they all have cell wall made up of cellulose, yes or no? They all are plants, so their cell wall is made up of cellulose, yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
So when we will eat cellulose in these forms, so we don't have cellulase, then what will happen? These things will come out of your body. Okay, what will happen? They will go in the stomach, like all the things will be digested, but cellulose part will be undigested because we don't have that enzyme. So when we don't have that enzyme, so that will remain, the cellulose will remain undigested and it will come out of the body. Is it okay? And when it will come out of the body, it will make our alimentary canal clean. Okay, so this all having cellulose, they all will come out of their body, come out of our body, not their body, and make the stomach clean. So that is why the person who is having problem of constipation, the doctor will advise to eat fiber things like these all things, because they will help in cleaning of the stomach and we will not get constipation. Why? Because we don't have cellulase we don't have, so cellulose will come out. Is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Pakka pakka. So take your time, please write it down. Chalo, theek hai, it means you are understanding. What is this? Achha, poll one. There is something poll. We can do this now in our class.
Yes, ma'am.
How do you use it?
We have to create a poll and display it. I am not sure how exactly to do it, but.
Suppose here is add a question option. And if I add a question, you will answer, and I hope those who will answer first, it will automatically show that this guy have answered quickly, so he will be at the top, something like that.
No, ma'am, it doesn't show you who has answered. It just gives you the percentage.
Oh, so let us try. Please complete the notes, then we will try this polling one. I will ask one question. Once you are done with this, please let me know. Once you are done, please let me know so that I can ask the questions. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Others also can use the mic.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, once the note is over, you have done the notes part. Let me know. I will ask few questions, like 2-3 questions. बहुत अच्छे अच्छे क्वेश्चंस हैं. अभी एक डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन इज फ्रॉम बायोगैस एंड आई होप एवरीबडी कैन गिव मी द करेक्ट आंसर बट लेट अस सी. 3-4 क्वेश्चंस आर कमिंग इन माय माइंड एंड आई विल मेंशन इट आल्सो द नेम ऑफ द ईयर एंड ऑल. Guys, writing. Hello.
Yes, ma'am. One second.
So just tell me because I don't know that what are you doing there.
Done, ma'am.
Very good.
Ma'am, where is the poll, ma'am?
See, poll is this. I have seen. I think we can use it in our class. Chalo, let us try today. Whatever will be there, we can discuss it. See there, polling. Can you see something on my screen?
No, ma'am.
Okay, so I think polling is not visible to you. Chalo, I will add a question. How to add a question?
Ma'am, we can probably do it next class. It's okay.
But okay, I will ask question. Chalo, question number one. Here I will write it also so that it will be in your notes. Everyone is ready? Prepare?
Yes, ma'am.
Here I will write previous year questions. Directly from doing, I am doing from the CBSE. Guidelines. Question number one. Which of the following in sewage treatment removes suspended solids? Removal of suspended solids. Which step? Sorry, which step of sewage treatment? Everybody have to give answer in the chat box. After
I'm removal of what?
Suspended solid particles.
Okay.
I will not give option round because I will give, but I just want you to tell me directly because this is easy. And guys, this is NEET 2017 question. I have to write here. NEET 2017. I hope chat is. No one have used.
Oh, ma'am, filtration.
No. Write your answer in the chat box. Everyone. Filtration, which is step of sewage treatment. Acha, or Shraddha has said filtration. Chalo, let me give you the option. Tertiary treatment, secondary treatment, primary treatment, sludge treatment. Abhi batao. Now tell me. Here I will write the option. What are the option? Tertiary treatment. Secondary treatment. I mean, nobody will speak, but everyone have to direct message me. Wait. Direct message, you know, in the chat box, how to do? Primary treatment and this is sludge treatment. Abhi, everyone, I am giving you 30 seconds. A, B, C, D. Your time starts now. NEET 2017. Bahut easy hai, bahut easy hai. Very good. What about the direct message? Only Shraddha has messaged me.
Ma'am, even I have texted you.
Tanmay entered the waiting room. What happened, Tanmay? Achha.
Ma'am, I'm changing my device, ma'am.
How to see? I can see only Shraddha message.
Oh, ma'am, I sent you a message also.
Where?
I also sent you.
Direct message.
Direct message like where? In this Zoom meeting?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, yaar. Ye ab dekhte kaise hain. Suppose I have written hi. But I am not able to view the direct messages. Oh, yeah. Aditya gave the answer. Tanmay gave the answer. Shraddha.
Ma'am, can you not see my message?
I can see message of Tanmay. Oh, Raghuram also have gave. Chalo. Direct message. Yes, I got to know how to do. So let me tell you, Raghuram is correct. Aditya is correct. Tanmay is correct. And Shraddha is also correct. Very good, girls and boys, everyone. Proud of you. It's primary treatment. See, primary is physical. Abhi, there is no need to make you understand. Question number two. Two questions I will ask, then we will have a break. Is that fine?
Yes, ma'am.
So what is question number two? Question number two is saying something to the sewage. Let me ask you. Not sewage. Kaliga puchte hain. East and east is used in the production of. East is used in the production of. I will not write the option. I will simply say the option. Okay, because it is very time taking. And again, you have to give me direct message. East is used in the production of, and the options are citric acid and lactic acid, lipase and pectinase, cheese and butter, bread and beer. Abhi ye to, this is so easy. Direct message 3 I got. Tanmay, Shraddha, Raghuram. Where are Shreyash and all? Aditya, Shreyash.
Ma'am, I guess Shreyash has gone to the washroom. He was not feeling well.
Oh. Is there any problem related to stomach?
I guess so, ma'am. He just told me he's not feeling well. He'll be back after
break.
A few minutes.
Okay. Theek hai. Take care. See, the option bread and beer is correct. I have told you. Now, who will explain the answer? Yesterday we discussed something. That saccharomyces is. Chalo, I will not speak. Raghuram, unmute yourself and tell me.
Ma'am, I'm not exactly sure about that, ma'am.
Shraddha, can you please do the same?
Ma'am, our bread and beer have to undergo fermentation and yeast is used for that.
And that is the reason that yeast, name of the yeast, first of all, tell me. Which yeast is used? This is asked in
Saccharomyces cerevisiae.
Very good. And they are used in the production of beer. They are also used in the production of bread. So they were having dual name also, I have told you. The same yeast is doing two things in two different industry. So what the name it got in two different industry? Anybody remember yesterday lecture? I hope Shreyash can give the answer. The same yeast is used in two places.
Mom, I didn't get your question.
My question is, this is bread industry, yes or no? Beer is made in beer industry, yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Both are using same yeast, yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
The yeast name is Saccharomyces cerevisiae. The same yeast. Now, the point is, when they are used in the formation of beer, in beer industry, it have one name, it get local name. And when it is used in the bread industry, then also they get one local name. This local name you have to tell me, these two. The yeast is same. The scientific name is same. Scientific name is not going to get changed. But the local name will be changed. And I want answer.
Ma'am, baker's yeast and brewer's yeast.
Very good. What's your name?
Ma'am, Shreyas.
Very good. See, I was saying that maybe Shreyas can tell because he was attentive in the last class. In bread industry, this Saccharomyces is well known as baker's yeast because it is helping in the baking process. So yeast will become baker yeast, and here it will become brewer's yeast. Fine. Abhi hata denge question mark. Is it okay? So this was 2012. One more question. Ready, everyone? Shall I ask one more? Is it fun answering question?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Next question is, question number three. During sewage treatment, biogases are produced, which include biogases are released. What are the things present in them? This is NEET 2013. NEET 2013. Answer I want. I think you don't, I don't need to give you options also, no? I'm waiting for the answer. Take your time. Biogas mein kya hoga? Okay. Direct answer I'm getting. Two messages I got. They both are correct. Proud of you, Shraddha and Raghunam. I want more answers. Tanmay, your answer is partially correct, guys. Oh, now he's complete. Oh, yes, yes. Come on, come write complete answer, Tanmay. Very good. Others are also writing? Methane, hydrogen sulfide, and carbon dioxide. Correct. Bahut achhe. Shabash, very good. CH4, H2S, CO2. Abhi yahan pe, in this all, there will be one more question which I have already discussed, but I am not going to discuss it again. Simply, I just want to ask, what is the percentage of methane in biogas?
Ma'am, do we say it or type it?
Oh, no, simply say it.
50 to 60%.
Very good. So here only I will write that whenever you check this notes for your study, revision, then you will get it. 50 to 60% is methane. Okay, so this is sewage treatment we have done today till now. And what we have done? We have done one more. Production of biogas, methanobacterium. After this, I will take a break. I will give you a break. Let me see how much is left. Microbes as biocontrol agent is left. And then microbes as biofertilizer is left. Two topics is left.
Ma'am, so, are we starting a new chapter today?
No. Do you want me to start?
No, ma'am.
Like, I am thinking that we will start fresh now from tomorrow.
Yes, ma'am, that'll be better.
Like, I just want the timing is 9 to 1. Is it fine? Like, maybe I will end this chapter by 12 o'clock only.
Yes, ma'am.
Is it fine that it is needed to be done like 9 to 12 only? Abhi 12 baje ho gaya, so everybody can go home.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. That'll be better.
That is better now because I think I can teach, but continuously 4 hours. Like, anyways, till Friday, my lecture is till 1 o'clock. So that is the margin I have to. But I will try to complete it like 12:30 is the maximum. I think that is good for your mental health also.
Ma'am, so you will start a new chapter tomorrow, and today we'll have class till 12 to 12:30.
Like till 12 o'clock, I will try to complete it.
Okay.
The schedule is given like 9 to 1 now.
Yes, ma'am.
So anybody have any problem if we complete the class at 12 or 12:30?
No problem, ma'am.
No problem, ma'am.
Okay. Chalo, then let us have a break. Break of how much minute you get? Yesterday, so I gave 15 minutes. 15 to 20, we got it.
Usually, that's how we get.
Okay, so chalo, let's have a break of 15 minutes. Hello everyone, 15 minutes is over.
Yes, ma'am, back.
Everyone is back. 15 minutes is done. See, I was, by mistake, I have done direct message to Tanmay, hello, because it was direct message chat open. Then I again typed it to everyone. So everyone is back.
Ma'am, I think there are still 3 minutes left.
Oh. Hmm. Okay, utilize your 3 minutes. Go and drink some water, eat something. Everyone is back.
Yes, ma'am.
Shraddha is there. Raghuram and Shreyash.
Yes, ma'am.
Tanmay.
Yes, ma'am.
Tanmay, is it like Tanmay or it's Tanmaya? Kya hai apna naam ka pronunciation? Tanmay?
Ma'am, it's Tanmaya. She's a girl.
She's a girl, na? Okay, fine. Tanmaya. Oh. Now I will be like very serious because after M-A-Y-A is there, na? So it will be Tanmaya. Okay, so as we are moving, proceeding to our chapter, we have done till microbes in production of biogas. Oh, Tanmaya entered the vent room. What happened? Wait a second. Okay, abhi shuru karte hain. Shall we start?
Ma'am, can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah, my pronunciation is Tanmaya.
Tanmaya. Okay, fine. Tanmaya. Am I correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Chalo. So now we are going to start microbe as biocontrol agents. Microbes as bio control agents. Now, what is the meaning of biocontrol? See, biocontrol means these microbes we will use in such a way that they will control other organisms in which context? Those organisms which are harmful. Okay? For example, if I say there is so much mosquito larva, so the government has one, you can say, biological method of control of mosquito larva. There is a fish. Can anybody tell me the name of the fish that eats mosquito larva? Name of the fish, we put it in the tank and then it will go and eat all the mosquito larva. In this way, we will get rid of mosquito larva, then there will be no mosquito. Kisko pata hai? Who knows? Shraddha, can you? Biocontrol agents mein, what is the name of the fish that eats mosquito larva? When there will be no mosquito, there will be no malaria. Abhi jisko nahi pata hai, they can say, ma'am, we don't know also.
Ma'am, we don't know.
Don't know, ma'am.
The name of the fish is Gambusia. Let me write here. Gambusia fish feeds upon mosquito larvae. So wherever there is stagnant water like this, and there are so many mosquito larvae, in order to get rid of these mosquito larvae, which fish we will allow to go there? We will put few fishes in them, and this is known as Gambusia fish. They will eat all the mosquito larva and then the water will become free of larvae. So in this way, what we have done, we have used one organism against another organism, and that against another organism is a harmful organism. Fine. So, but in this whatever I have told, Gambusia fish, so this is a fish now, this is normal example I told you. But in this topic, microbe as biocontrol agent, we will use microbes. So understand the topic. Here the microbes that we will use. Microbes, or I will write microorganisms, will be used against other organisms. These other organisms are useful or harmful?
Harmful.
That is why we are using. Otherwise, if they are useful, then why we will kill them? These other organisms are harmful. So in this category, number one, First of all, normally, if there are insects in your farm, you are a farmer, you are doing farming. ठीक है? There you have a farm. So if there is insect, lot of insects in your farm, this is a piece of land, it is full of insects. So what you will use, which chemical you use normally? अभी बताओ, grade 9 में you have done. Chemical against insect.
Insecticide.
Very good. Insecticide. If there is unwanted plant, suppose this is your main plant, this blue is your main plant, suppose wheat plant, along with this main plant, some unnecessary things are also grown. What are these unnecessary things?
Weeds.
Very good. Weeds. So in order to get rid of weeds, what we will do? Use which chemical? Weedicide. Am I correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Chalo. Ab here, suppose insect was there, some more insects come, unwanted things come in your farm. Like what was there? Tiddi gang. What was the English name of that tiddi? Aphids. No. What is the English name of tiddi? I don't remember. Who will tell me? बहुत सारी टिड्डी आके दे एट ऑल द क्रॉप्स ऑफ द प्लांट.
पेस्ट्स.
नो नो, टिड्डी इन इंग्लिश, मैं आपको बताती हूँ. मैं टिड्डी इन इंग्लिश इज नोन एज, अरे कहाँ गया, टिड्डी इंसेक्ट इन इंग्लिश नोन एज लोकस्ट. हाँ अभी याद आया, लोकस्ट. LOCUST. हैव यू सीन द डेंजरस इम्पैक्ट ऑफ लोकस्ट इन कोविड? दे वर कमिंग इन ग्रुप, झुंड में आके ऐसे पूरा आतंक मचा के. हैव यू सीन इन न्यूज पेपर एंड न्यूज चैनल लोकस्ट? LOCUST. यू वॉन्ट टू सी इन यूट्यूब? से यस और नो.
व्हाट मैम?
लोकस्ट. आई होप एवरीबडी हियर इज इन द क्लास. लोकस्ट इज अ इंसेक्ट दैट इज गिविंग हार्म टू योर farm. Let me tell you, this locust is known as tiddi. Abhi batate hain locust attack. Now abhi ye dekh ke samajh aa jayega. What is this happening? See, do you see, this is a farm and there's so much insect, this known as locust. This in Hindi it's called tiddi. See, they are coming in the farm and destroying the crops. Farmers are so much worried. Can you see this? My screen is visible.
Yes, ma'am.
Have you noticed such type of news? Old days, ancient days, abhi ek do mahina pehle, before 6 months.
Yes, ma'am. There was a locust attack even in India, like recently.
So locust attack. So locust is a type of weed or it's type of pest?
Pest.
Very good. So I will come back to my slide. So if there is unwanted things, unwanted insects, they will known as pest. Okay. And these pests are killed by a chemical known as pesticides. Still here? Any doubts? अभी कोई doubt है? Speak, class.
No doubt, ma'am.
Everyone?
No doubt.
These insecticide, pesticide, weedicide, are they useful to your soil or they are harmful? For soil, they are useful or harmful?
Harmful.
Harmful. So what we have done, why they are harmful? Because when you will put these chemicals in your land, if you will put this chemical over your plant, like spray and all, weedicides will get spray on this. So these chemical will go inside the plant body. And when we will eat that plant, that chemical will come in our body. So there will be transfer of chemicals from one tropic level to another tropic level. And then they can cause diseases. And this phenomena in biology is known as biomagnification. I hope you have heard the word. Bio, have you heard it or not? Say yes or no.
Ma'am, can you repeat what biomagnification is?
Biomagnification, I will write. Definition likho, the increase in the concentration of chemicals at successive tropic levels. At successive tropic level. The increase in the concentration of chemicals at successive tropic level is known as biomagnification. Is it clear? So biomagnification is useful or harmful? Whole class will tell me. Tanmaya will tell me biomagnification is useful or harmful. Tanmaya, I have pronounced your name properly, so you have to tell me, is it good or is it harmful?
Ma'am, I think harmful.
Harmful. See, chemicals will come in the plant. Plant we will eat. The chemicals will come in our body. Lead poisoning, mercury poisoning. You remember there was a fish. I don't remember. But there was not exactly, that is important also. There was a fish. That fish was in a water. And in that water, we have used some chemicals that is coming from industry, water pollution. The fish was have absorbed that chemical. Now those people who love to eat fish, they eat that fish. And by the help of that fish, they got mercury in their body. And there is a mercury poisoning in the body of the human, which leads to a disease known as Minamata disease. Have you heard this? Those who love to eat fish, suppose the fish is living in water, the water there is toxic, there is mercury, there is lead, there is arsenic, there are so, so dangerous things in the water. So the fish will absorb all those dangerous things. And when we will eat the fish, we will absorb that dangerous thing. And then our nervous system will not support it. And then we got a disease known as Minamata disease. Abhi kisi ne suna hai iska naam? What is this Minamata disease? Say yes or no.
No, ma'am.
Okay, so I will show you. Abhi, these all things are in grade 9 and 10. Nah? I am teaching 9, 10th students. They know. You were in Centum only, nah, in 9th and 10th?
Not in 9th, ma'am.
Oh, see, this is. Abhi iska thoda, let me show you here. See. Minamata disease is a neurological disease. यही से सीधा है, I will explain you. Caused by severe mercury poisoning. See, mercury is so dangerous. Thermometer is also having mercury, yes or no? Thermometer. Thermometer. Which chemical is in thermometer? अरे chemistry question is basic question. ऐसे कैसे निकलेगा exam? Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Mercury is a dangerous, it is a harmful chemical that was present in thermometer before. So that thermometer we have replaced. Now we have digital thermometer. Because that previous thermometer, when kids get in their mouth to check fever, they chew it. And there is a risk of mercury going in the body. Mercury is dangerous because it will damage your neurons, guys. So Minamata disease is a neurological disease caused by severe mercury poisoning. So those people, see, this is a fish. This fish is having mercury in the body. Hg is the formula, na? Am I not? Hg hoga formula? Kya hai mercury ka formula? Arre bolo bhai.
HG.
MG or HG?
HG.
HG.
Oh, MG किसका है? What is MG then?
Ma'am, MG is magnesium.
Magnesium. चलो, thank God you know this. So HG is mercury. So mercury will go in the body of fish and this fish will be eaten by human. So mercury will go in the body of human and this mercury will get react with the neurons and then it will cause mercury poisoning and the disease is Minamata disease. इसमें क्या होगा? What will happen? Numbness in the head and feet, muscles weakness, loss of vision, damage of ear, speech. सब कुछ गड़बड़ हो जाएगा. Is it okay? Now did you got to know that how these chemicals, how this biomagnification is so much dangerous? The biomagnification is good or bad?
It's bad.
It's bad. It's not good for your health. So in order to get rid of this biomagnification and phalana, dimkana and everything, what we have done? What the human have done, human is smartly used microbe. So microbes ko use karke what we have to do? We have to protect our crops. So first thing, first of all, this one of the common weedicide is also dangerous. First of all, let me tell you, weedicide is also not good. Insecticide, pesticide, sab bakwas hai. Weedicide, the name of the weedicide is glyphosate. Glyphosate एक ऐसा weedicide है. This is a neat MCQ. This is herbal. Okay? And this is harmful for human. So name the weedicide that is herbal and harmful for human. So your answer will be glyphosate. ठीक? So what we have to do, instead of using these chemicals, we will try to use some microbe that can kill other dangerous animal. But what we have to take care, what we need to notice, when we kill any insect, guys, write it down. When we kill any insect, we kill food of any other animal in our ecosystem. Who can explain me this statement? So with this we need to take care. Whenever we are killing any insect, we are killing any animal, we should keep it in our mind that we are killing food of any other animal also. How? Raghuram will explain the whole class. Raghuram?
Yes, ma'am.
Chalo batao. My statement, whatever I have written, how you will understand it?
Ma'am, what do I explain here, ma'am?
Here you have to explain that I am saying that there is a food chain. In food chain, I am killing one organism. I'm using my microbe. I'm becoming very super duper intelligent and I'm trying to kill one insect. So at the same time, I'm killing the food of any other animal. How? How? If you can't, then you can say also, ma'am, we don't know. You explain it.
Ma'am, you only explain. I don't know how to explain the statement.
But you understood?
Yes, ma'am. I understood that.
See, ab yahan pe we will understand in a more better way. Suppose there is an insect that is not good for us, insect that is harmful. I have killed this insect, okay, using microbe or any other technique. But at the same time, this insect is behaving like a food for birds now. This insect is food for birds. So if I kill the insect, directly I kill the insect, don't you think that indirectly I am killing the bird? When birds will not get their food, they will kill, they will be no more. Yes or no? Yes or no? if we will kill all the insects that is present in this universe, then what the bird will eat? We are killing the food of birds. So in this way, indirect method of birds are also getting killed. Now have you understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Pakka, don't tell lie. Pakka, pakka, batao. Samajh mein aa gaya?
Yes.
Okay, then the next topic that we are going to start is, not next topic, few examples in this contest I would like to give you. That is previous year question. The heading will be previous year questions. Let me make it. There is no space. Another slide. Previous year questions. अभी देखो इस पे क्या आया है, क्या क्या क्वेश्चन है. प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन पी वाई क्यू. अभी देखो लेडी बर्ड, हाउ मेनी किड्स हैव हर्ड दिस नेम लेडी बर्ड. आई हैड वन बाइसिकल व्हेन आई वाज स्मॉल, लाइक स्मॉल एज ऑफ 9th and 10th. 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th. My grandmother, my grandfather purchased me a cycle, purple color. The name was Lady Bird. It was having one basket also. Then I put my water bottle and everything, and then I use that cycle and go to my school. Have you heard the name Lady Bird?
Yes.
So this Lady Bird here, it is not a cycle. Okay. Lady bird and dragonfly. ये क्या है? These two are what? Lady bird and dragonfly. चलो, here I will put one image. So why there is so much silence in the class? Getting bored. Class, what happened?
No, mom, we're not getting bored.
फिर क्या हो गया?
Mom, ladybird is a bug.
Ladybird and dragonflies. Wait, I have to. I just want one image of that.
Mom, both of them are insect.
हाँ, तो both are insect. Ladybird, ये देखो. Don't you think that it is a beetle?
Yes, ma'am.
कुछ बीटल जैसा. अभी ये वाला यूज करते हैं, दिस इज मोर ब्यूटीफुल. सेव कर ली इमेज. ओके, सो दिस इज एलबी. एंड वन मोर, व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ अनदर?
ड्रैगन फ्लाई.
ड्रैगन फ्लाई बहुत खतरनाक नाम है. ड्रैगन, देयर वाज अ शो ऑन कार्टून नेटवर्क ड्रैगन बॉल जी, आई रिमेम्बर. ये देखो ड्रैगन फ्लाई, ये एवरीबॉडी हैव सीन. This comes in rainy season. When there is so much rain in north side, then it's come. This is DF. ठीक? These two images I will use in the notes also. अभी यहाँ पे I will put it. So what these two insect will do? Ladybird and dragonfly are useful to get rid from aphids and mosquitoes. अभी what they two will do? They will eat aphids and mosquito. So everyone listen, here we are not using any chemical to kill aphid and mosquito. We are using one animal against another animal. Yes or no? Yes or no? Have you understood what I want to speak?
Yes, ma'am.
I am saying that instead of using chemicals, here we are using... Oh, where is that image? Just a second. Document.
It will be in downloads.
Yeah, but download. This is frog. What is this? It's not there.
Ma'am, check recents.
This is only now where all the images come normally. Revive, I'm going here. This is recent. Frog, WhatsApp and all, previous 7 days, then application. But I remember it was in download only. This is desktop. Okay, then this is download.
Ma'am, there was an LB image.
Hmm.
Ma'am, check desktop again.
Yeah, this is the LB. Oh, yeah. This is ladybird. And I have one dragonfly also. Now I have written DF.
Yes,
ma'am. Wait. I will get it. ये ऑनलाइन क्लास में सब होता है दिस इज डीएफ ना सी वेयर इट इज वेयर आई हैव डाउनलोडेड इट कहां गया ये या हियर इट इज ना दिस इज डेस्कटॉप ओनली सो हियर आई कैन यूज फ्रॉम डेस्कटॉप It's not there. Can you find it?
Ma'am, you can just search for DF. There's a search bar, right?
चलो कोई बात नहीं आई डोंट नो वेयर इट इज सो डायरेक्टली यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड बट आई जस्ट वांट टू पुट दैट पिक्चर हियर
वी कैन डाउनलोड वन अगेन
या आई थिंक दैट विल बी द बेटर गाइस जस्ट गिव मी अ मिनट आई एम गेटिंग एन इमरजेंसी कॉल वेट kids, I can see that it is getting saved in the what we say desktop something. Na? Abhi dekhte hain. Ye dekho aa gaya. Oops, I have done something gadbad, I think. So these are two insects that will kill aphids and mosquito. First one is ladybird. Let me write it. And the second one is dragonfly. These two we will use against aphids and mosquito. So first of all here, the important to learn is insects belongs to which order? Insects belongs to order Coleopterans. This is something from diversity chapter, Animal Kingdom. But still I am writing here because it is important. And butterfly belongs to order Lepidoptera. We call it Lepidoptera. Order Lepidoptera. So guys, please see. Using these two insects, we are killing these two dangerous insects. So is it biocontrol method? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
So please, yes, ma'am. This two write down.
Ma'am, you are muted. We can't hear you.
Hello, now I'm audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so let us do again. Ab dekho, here butterfly. Butterfly is beautiful, na? Everybody loves butterfly. Belongs to order Lepidoptera. Colorful butterflies are also there. But this larva of butterfly is infecting so many plants. So what we can ask? Larva of butterfly infects many plants. So what we need to do? We need to control this or not? We need to control it. If it is infecting so many plants, we need to control, but we will use biological method. So in biological method, what we will do? We have genetically prepared BT cotton. What is BT cotton? Biotech chapter, have you done?
Yes, ma'am, doing.
So BT cotton is one of the first application applied in India from biotechnology. There is a disease known as boll worms. Abhi cotton ka diagram bana de. Suppose this is a cotton. Just wait, I'm trying to draw something. Ye dekho. What is this cotton ball? Is it correct? Is it correct? What is the color of cotton balls? What is the color of cotton balls? Are bhai, bolo, what happened? Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
So why are you not audible to me? What is this?
Cotton fiber balls.
Cotton fiber balls. Now if I say that this beautiful cotton ball, here I will label it. These are cotton balls. If I say that the larvae of butterfly, a beautiful butterfly, I will draw. Beautiful butterfly. Chalo dekho aise karke. Aise aa gaya. This is my beautiful. Quite funny. See, the butterfly is coming. The larva is also coming. Larvae of butterfly is also there. So what these both dangerous, these beautiful looking queen, they will give disease to this cotton ball. Why? They will get black spot. Okay, this black spot, what will happen? This will have, this is known as boll worms. Understood? They are worms. So we need to get rid of this or not? If we will not get rid of this, all the cotton balls will be damaged, and how will we make cotton cloth? Yes or no? Batao, jaldi, use your mic.
Yes, ma'am.
Abhi ek minute de do. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Sorry for the disturbance. The laundry person is calling me again and again. Then, ma'am, please come get your clothes. I told that I am busy. I am in class, continuously calling. So sorry for the disturbance. This only happens work from home. So boll worms are not good. They will infect the cotton. This cotton plant will be infected. when cotton plant will be infected, what will happen to the cotton industry? There is a big question mark. So in order to get rid of these boll worms, we have genetically prepared BT cotton. Abhi BT cotton kya hai? What is BT cotton? BT cotton mein, this BT, the full form is Bacillus thuringiensis. Bacillus thuringiensis. Abhi we will follow binomial nomenclature, genus name underline, species name first letter, small, species name underline. Ho gaya? Done? So, what is this? Bacillus hai, toh ye kya hai? Who will tell me? Bacillus. Tell me. Tell.
Ma'am, rod shaped bacteria.
Very good. What's the name?
I'm Shreyas.
Yes, very good, Shreyas. See, Bacillus is rod shaped bacteria. So, we will design cotton using a special rod shaped bacteria, and that cotton will known as BT cotton. Theek hai? So what will be, how it will be useful? Abhi dikhate hain. Here I will make one more cotton. Everybody please draw it in your book. Abhi dekho, this is
stem. Ma'am, can you show the previous part for one sec? Right.
Done.
One second, ma'am.
Okay, take your time.
Excuse me, ma'am. Hmm? Ma'am, could you just repeat the role of the larvae in this infection again?
Role of the
butterfly larvae, ma'am.
See, butterfly is a very beautiful insect, but the larva of butterfly is not good because it will go near the cotton plant and it will, this larva will go near this this cotton white and the larva will cause infection. It will give worms to it and then the cotton will have black worms. This is known as
ma'am, so boll worms come from the larvae of butterfly.
See, it's not like always larvae of the butterfly. Boll worms are something different also. One group of insect is that is in giving infection to this cotton. But larvae of butterfly will also participate in this. So larvae of butterfly is also, you can say, pest. Pest, na, that unwanted insect. Have you done this?
Yes, ma'am, done. Thank you.
Ab yahan pe aate hain that what we have done. So we have developed which cotton? What was the name of the cotton genetically engineered?
BT cotton.
BT cotton. Or BT cotton mein which bacteria was there?
Bacillus thuringiensis.
Bacillus thuringiensis. Ab hum karenge isko. Dekho, ye white color ka cotton ho gaya. Ab in this cotton, first I will make it complete white. In this, what we have to do, this is taking little time, so don't worry. We have time. So this cotton is having rod-shaped bacteria. It is designed in such a way, biotechnology and genetic engineering has designed this cotton in such a way that it has become BT cotton. This is known as BT cotton. अब देखो सपोज बैक्टीरिया लार्वी इज कमिंग, बॉल वॉर्म्स आर कमिंग, बैक्टीरिया ओ सॉरी बटरफ्लाई लार्वी, लार्वा ऑफ बटरफ्लाई, ओके वन. सेकेंड इज हु? बॉल वॉर्म्स. These both will come and they will attack cotton. But this cotton is not an ordinary cotton. This cotton is, this cotton is genetically engineered BT cotton. Okay. So now this ball worm, when it will attack on this BT cotton, the BT, the bacillus, the rod-shaped bacteria will enter in the gut of bacillus, will enter in the gut of ball worms. Is it okay? And what is the medium of gut? Alkaline. So this alkaline medium of the ball worms as well as of the larvae of butterfly, they will get infected by this rod-shaped bacteria bacillus. So there will be a cry gene. Okay, what is this cry gene? So cry gene will be activated. This is also present in the gut. So the gut is having two things. First is alkaline medium. Second is cry gene. They both will, as soon as this gut will come in contact with this bacillus, as soon as they will go near the cotton ball worms, their alkaline medium gut and the cry gene will be quickly activated. Okay? And as soon as they will be activated, then this ball worm, kya hoga? The ball worms will have holes in their gut, guys. Who is causing this hole? Who is causing this hole?
Mom, cry gene will be activated by the bacillus.
The cry gene in the ball worms, it will be activated, and for getting activation it needs alkaline medium. So gut is also alkaline in nature. So balle balle, you know, they will get plus point.
Ma'am, why is the cry gene present in the gut if it's harmful?
No, so cry gene is not harmful na. If the bacillus will come, then it will become harmful. Normally, okay. It is not harmful. So we are designing such a smart na bacillus thuringiogenesis cotton. Genetic engineering is very good. So, hum aisa bana denge. So, what will happen? As soon as the bacillus will come in the gut of the ball worms, gut is already alkaline, gut is having cry gene, then what will happen? They both will be activated. They will cause, they will go and react with the bacteria, bacillus. Then the bacillus will cause holes in their gut. Ab jo holes ho jayega, then what will happen? Suppose this is ball worms, then there will be holes. Abhi kya ho jayega? After hole, the bacillus, this ball worm will die. Is it okay? Is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
So do you think that BT cotton is good?
It is good.
It is good. So it is a, see, bacillus is one bacteria. It is used again, ball worms. So what we are using? Are we using any chemical here to control these disease? Are we using any chemical? Say yes or no. Here, do we use any chemical to kill this ball worm? Arre, bolo, bolo, bolo. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
No. Kahan chemical use hua? We haven't used any chemical. We have used bacillus microbe. Microbe hai, that is bacillus. Matlab what it is? Bacteria na. Rod-shaped bacteria is a microbe. So one microbe is used to kill another, you can say, insect. So this is biological control. Microbe. Ma'am. Biocontrol, yes.
Ma'am, didn't you say did not use chemical?
Did not use. Okay, then so you were correct. See, guys, if I have done any sort of things that it's remain unexplained to you, please let me know. See, yahan pe kuch chemical we don't have to use because we are understanding the topic microbes as biocontrol agents. Nah? So microbe is only our chemical. So we will use microbe against another organism that is causing harm to us. Is it okay? Is it okay? Again, you all are silent. Ab kya ho gaya? Now what happened?
Nothing, ma'am.
See, to abhi pichle slide mein I will go. I will add one more knowledge to you. This BT cotton, jo hai yahan pe, like this is normal cotton. How does it get BT cotton? So yahan pe there will be a BT spores. ठीक है, BT spores combined with water, then there is a see device. We will give water to this ball worm and then BT will go inside. Have you understood now? Spray करना है, spray. Like you spray water on your plants, you have
yes,
to
ma'am.
Water plus BT spores on the BT cottons. Wherever you will put it, the things will become BT, and then BT will, if any insect will go there, if any insect will come near this BT thing, the bacillus will go in the gut of that insect and make holes and make them die. Okay?
Oh, yes, ma'am.
Now next. This we have done. There is one more fungus that we can use. Yahi pe likh dete hain, if there is a space, Trichoderma. Trichoderma is a free living fungi. Trichoderma is a free living fungi that can control plant pathogen. So any pathogen that is coming on plant, so instead of using here bacteria, bacillus was bacteria, we are using one fungi that is Trichoderma. So see, one microbe is used against the control of other microbes. So this is known as biocontrol. Then?
Ma'am, plant pathogen in the sense?
Plant pathogen, those pathogen which attacks on plant.
Ma'am, so can it be used for bollworms also?
It can be used, but it was not successful for bollworms because Cry gene was not getting activated. It got activated only when it got attacked by Bacillus bacteria. Tabhi hua hai uska.
Okay, ma'am.
Abhi ek aur virus hai. This is fungi. Abhi ek, this we have done fungi. This we have done Bacillus bacteria. There is one virus, Baculovirus. Baculoviruses are pathogens against insects. Okay, against insects and arthropoda. Bhi NCERT mein arthropoda bhi likh diya, but both are same na guys. Arthropoda is a something that have insects. So this baculovirus belongs to one genus. This is neat MCQ. Nucleopolyhedrovirus. Nucleopolyhedrovirus. Done. This is neat MCQ. Is it okay?
One second, ma'am.
Write it down. Take your time. Once you are done, let me know because I need to change the page. Done. Done, done, done.
Ma'am, could you scroll down?
Okay. These notes I will give you, don't worry.
Ma'am, could you send the yesterday class notes also?
I have given in the group, na?
You have?
Yes. What is the name of the group? NEET 2022, na? Wait. CA 12 NEET 2022.
Yes, ma'am. I didn't see it. Sorry, ma'am.
Okay. Chalo, fir, may I go to the last topic of this chapter? And today we will complete this chapter. Today we will complete this chapter. Have you written all these things?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. Now, last topic is microbes as biofertilizers. Here, biofertilizer is not any chemical or not any fertilizer. We will use organisms as biofertilizer. So first thing that you need to get clear is biofertilizer is not any chemical. It's not in the powdered form. It is organism that will enriches the fertility of the soil. It will increase the fertility of the soil. So that's why it will be known as biofertilizer. So last topic of our class, microbes. See, these microbes are so useful that we can use it as a weapon against so many diseases. So microbes as biofertilizers. Should I write down the definition of biofertilizer or it's not needed because it's already mentioned in the NCERT? You want me to write it down?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So biofertilizers are what? Who will tell me? Chalo, main likh nahi rahi hu. I'm not going to write, but please make me assure that you have understood. So anybody in the class can give the answer. Tanmaya, can you please?
Mom, like the definition of...
Definition, like simply in your own words. You don't have to write a definition in any exam or something. Like in board exam, they will ask you. Then you have to write beautifully using proper words and all. But now in class, simply tell in your words that what do you understand by biofertilizer?
Organisms which can enrich the fertility of the soil.
Mom, like a living organism that's used as a fertilizer.
Very good. Any example that comes in your mind that we can use it as a biofertilizer? Shreyash will tell this answer. Hi, Shreyash. Any organism you remember? We are doing this since grade 7. I will not give you hint. Shreyash, am I audible?
Oh, yes, ma'am. I'm not sure, ma'am. I don't recollect any.
No. You are not sure, but you can guess it now at least. Anybody who would like to guess? Raghuram?
Ma'am, can I try? Don't know.
What?
Ma'am, can I try?
This is Shraddha?
Yes, ma'am.
Tell Shraddha, will tell one example.
Ma'am, rhizobium.
Rhizobium, very good. See, we are doing since childhood that rhizobium, what it is this a bacteria, fungus, what it is? Who will tell? Rhizobium is what? Which microbe it is?
Ma'am, is it a nitrogen fixing bacteria?
Very good. In nitrogen cycle, we have done that rhizobium is a bacteria that fixes nitrogen and it is present in the root nodules of which plant? Leguminous plant. Now, what is the meaning of leguminous plant? Legumes, pea plant, better example. So, in the root nodules of a leguminous plant, there is a bacteria, pinkish color I have used to write the name of the bacteria, the same pink color. Oh, this is brown. The same pink color I will use to make the diagram of the bacteria. Chalo, aise thoda thoda samajh lete hain that there is rhizobium bacteria present in the root nodules of the leguminous plant. So what this rhizobium bacteria will do? It will helps in nitrogen fixation. So when nitrogen will be there in the soil, the soil will be fertile or non-fertile? Soil will be fertile or non-fertile?
Fertile.
Fertile, obviously. So there are, rhizobium is number one application. Chalo, there are so many na. One. Ab number two pe, what I will write? Azo spirillum. Ye bhi bacteria hai, and one more. Azotobacter. These all I hope you have done in nitrogen cycle. Bio-geochemical cycle padha hoga. Azospirillum and Azotobacter. Thik hai? These spelling is correct. Bacteria likh diya maine. Likhte likhte. Aadat pad gayi hai. Azotobacter. I am used of writing bacteria. So I have written it. So Azospirillum, Azotobacter, they will also enriches the nitrogen content of the soil. Nitrogen content. So what they will do? Increase. Okay? They will make the soil fertile. Third is genus Glomus. There is a Glomus belonging to phylum, this is an organism that is from genus Glomus. It will have fungal relationship, symbiotic relation. Symbiotic mein kya hoga? What is symbiotic relationship?
And both are dependent on each other for survival.
Very good. Give and take. I will give you, you give me something. So they will make a symbiotic relationship. Symbiotic relationship with banayenge, and what is the name of the symbiotic relationship? Mycorrhiza. In this, what there will be? The fungal symbiont in this, the relationship mein there will be 2 persons, yes or no? Batao. Relationship mein how many people are there at least? If any relationship is there, then how many
people? Two people.
So Glomus, one is Glomus is what? ग्लोमस इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ फंजाई, ठीक है, तो ग्लोमस इज फंजाई. अभी एंड व्हाट इज द नेक्स्ट फंजाई, वन पर्सन, सेकेंड पर्सन विद हुम द रिलेशनशिप इज देयर, रूट्स. नाउ वी कैन से देयर इज रिलेशनशिप एट लीस्ट, कम से कम एट लीस्ट देयर शुड बी टू पीपल टू मेक एनी रिलेशनशिप. So in this relationship, that is name of the relationship is mycorrhiza. This is a symbiotic relationship. In this relationship, fungi will absorb phosphorus. Fungi will absorb phosphorus. So when the fungi will absorb phosphorus, then the root will become, root will have which thing? Like I say that me and Shraddha are friends. We are living in one room like one apartment we have. We both are sharing, we are living together. And Shraddha is very good. Shraddha is fond of eating ice cream. So she bring ice cream every day. So I am also living in the same room. So obviously I will also get the chance to get the ice cream. Say yes or no. If Shraddha will bring the ice cream every day, so she will offer me, na?
Yes, ma'am.
But that depends upon the friendship. So if she will offer me, so I will also get the opportunity to eat ice cream. Similarly, the roots are living with fungi. They both are in relationship, living together, symbiotic relationship. So the fungus that is getting phosphorus, this fungus, the fungi is getting that phosphorus, the fungi will give it to the roots. And the roots will become phosphorus rich. And phosphorus is a, what are the three macronutrients of soil? Batao jaldi jaldi. Three macronutrients of soil. Who will tell? Macro required in large quantity. Macronutrients of soil. Nitrogen. Phosphorus. Keep it in your mind. And potassium. So kitna ho gaya? How many these are? N, P, K. Nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. Is it okay? Is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Pakka? Any doubts?
No, ma'am.
Okay, so this you have to understand. After this, mycorrhiza, we have understood ki ek aisa relationship in which the soil will get phosphorus. Before this, Azotobacter azospirillum will give nitrogen. Rhizobium will also give nitrogen. So we don't use any chemical, fertilizer, manure, nothing. Microbes are there. They will do everything. Is it okay? So those plants which have this mycorrhiza relationship, those plants which have this type of friendship, this relationship, what benefit they will get? First benefit they will have. Chalo, you will understand this also. Benefits. Pahla benefit, first benefit is that resistance of root-borne pathogen. So the root will be healthy. There will be resistance. Resistance means, everybody know physics term. Kya hoga resistance? What is resistance? Suppose current is flowing. Current is not flowing.
Opposition.
Opposition. Thik? So root pathogen there will be not. If there will be no pathogen, then root will be healthy or unhealthy. No pathogen. Root healthy, unhealthy.
Ma'am will be healthier.
Healthy. Thik? Dusra benefit kya hai? What is second benefit? Tolerance. It can tolerate. The plant can tolerate saline condition and drought condition, that when there is not enough water, then also it can survive. When the water is having salt, then also it can survive. So is it good now? So you will get two benefits. After this, the last is here only. I will write it down. I will make one pink column. Cyanobacteria. What is the other name of cyanobacteria? Cyanobacteria. Can I call it blue-green alga? Yes or no? They both are same. Cyanobacteria is belonging to which kingdom? Monera. Okay. Now this Monera is the first one to evolve oxygen. Everybody remember na? Bacteria is the first living organism. Batao, do you remember? First living organism found on earth. Primitive they are. First living organism to evolve oxygen or release oxygen. Thik? This is something that we have to learn. After this, this kingdom Monera will also have some more. Anabena, bacteria ka naam hai. These all are bacteria. Nostoc. These all are in plants, guys. They will help in enriching the fertility of the soil. Oscillatoria. These all belongs to kingdom Monera. They all will, what their motto is in the life. What these have to do? Increases the soil fertility. Or kya karna hai? Or, and what they have to do in their life? These all Monerans, what they have to do? Increases the soil fertility and make plant healthy. Their agenda is, like my agenda is to complete this chapter today, and their agenda is to make the plant healthy and enriches the fertility of the soil. So have you understood that without using chemical, without using manure, without using anything extra, we can use microbe only to enrich the fertility of the soil? Is it okay? Is it okay, guys?
Yes, ma'am. Can you show us benefits again?
Okay, right on. Benefits kahan tha? Acha, ye.
Come to your left.
Yeah.
Ma'am, the other one, towards the left.
Why this is stuck? These are the benefits.
I'm done, ma'am. Could you move to the right a bit?
Done.
1 minute.
Take your time. After this, I will add two questions. Thinking to add. Ooh, I have two questions in my book. Yes. We will continue this lecture till 12:30. Is that fine, guys?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Chalo, once you have done with notes, let me know.
Done, ma'am.
Done. Others? Shall I? May I ask you questions? Kids, may I change the slide?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am.
So, yahan pe ho gaya previous year questions. First question I will directly ask. I will not write whole question because obviously it will take time. So, question, how many questions we have done before this? Three or four?
Three.
So here I will start with question number four. The question is saying, listen my question carefully. A patient brought to a hospital with myocardial infarction is normally immediately given with. Everybody have to give direct message. Let me open my direct message. Where is chat? Chalo. Oh, so options are penicillin, streptokinase, cyclosporin, statins. Myocardial infarction hua hai patient, what the doctor will give quickly. Direct I answer, I want. Have you understood the question?
Ma'am, could you repeat the question?
A patient is having myocardial infarction. He comes to hospital. Doctor advise him to give penicillin, streptokinase, cyclosporin, statins.
And statins.
Right, direct and direct message karo. Everybody direct message me in the chat. Don't say the answer. Understand the question. Two answer I got. Shreyash Raghuram. Others? Achha, Aditya has also given the answer. Statin. Others? Sab de diye statin. Everyone is wrong. The answer is streptokinase. Re Bhagwan, aise hi tum log galat kar dena. How you will write neat like this? Strepto. Kinase. Now see what will happen in streptokinase. Streptokinase will is a clot buster. Na, I have told you. Statin, which you are telling, it will lower the cholesterol level. So it is not a quick effect. Abhi turan person is having heart attack. So you will give a streptokinase. Statins will given later on. Next question. This question, let me write the year 2012. Question number five. Question five is asking, which one of the following is not a biofertilizer? Rhizobium, nostoc, mycorrhiza, agrobacterium. Not a biofertilizer. 2008 ka question.
Ma'am, can you repeat the options?
Options are rhizobium, nostoc, mycorrhiza, agrobacterium. Who will tell? Come on. Agrobacterium. Shraddha has given the correct and quick reply. I will not give you more than 30 seconds. Chalo, next question. Question number 6. The question is asking, a common biocontrol agent for the control of plant disease. Common biocontrol agent to control plant disease. Abhi, now you will ask, ma'am, option kya hai? What is the option? So the before telling you the option, I will go with the year, that in which year this question came. The year is 2010. Oh, 2010. So the answer will be, but option kya hai? Baculovirus, Bacillus thuringiensis, Glomus, Trichoderma. So confusion. I got one answer, but still I want more answers. Only Shraddha gave the answer. Others? Others, give me the answer. If you don't know, everyone write down in the chat box IDK. Jisko nahi pata hai, they will write IDK. At least you have to be little responsive in the class. Everyone is there or somebody left the lecture also? Class is going on. I don't know. Okay. So, I hope that you are thinking that, ma'am, every option I think is the correct. But guys, the correct answer is Trichoderma. Now I will tell you why this Trichoderma. Trichoderma is a fungus that is present in all plant. In all plant soil. So this is common. See the word? I have written common. In all plant soil. Thik? Understood? So now I will save this page. This is the microbes in human welfare, part 2. It will be in desktop. Chalo, theek hai. JPG, PDF, all. Save. Now I will go to, where should I go? Who is the participant list is there? So now I will take the attendance. Who is missing, guys?
Ma'am, what, ma'am?
Is there anybody who is absent also today?
Not sure, ma'am.
Achha, what is the total number of people? Bio need 12.
Ma'am, Anumita, Ananya, and Kirtana are not there.
Anumita, Ananya, and Kirtana. Okay. And why these kids are absent? They were in last lecture. In Rahul sir class, were they present?
Ma'am, Ananya was there. Anumita is traveling, so she won't be joining.
And Kirtana?
Ma'am, I'm not sure.
Okay, chalo, koi baat nahi. But please, guys, tell everyone that class is going on and we have to complete the syllabus along with time. So this is winter pending planner. In this winter, we all are trying to make your syllabus little like kuch chapters ho jayenge. These 4-5 chapters will be over, then you will feel light. Where is part 2? Small this. Okay, it is in desktop now. Microbes in CVCB have started. So have you understand anything today? Give little feedback.
It was finally, ma'am. We understood.
We understood everything.
Okay, then everyone can leave. Bye-bye. Take care.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you, ma'am.